the reason we wanted to turn it into a book was because we both felt, first of all, we're big readers, both of us, and love to read fiction. And we feel like people are busy, and when they want to read something, I know that I personally want to escape into a fictional world. And we felt that the DC scene really was ripe for some satire, and there were some, you know, storylines that we wanted to write about based on our experiences here. And in particular, both being transplants from other places, which a lot of people are in DC, we felt that it's a whole different world out here. People are very formal, very uptight, very type A. And if you can't poke fun and laugh at it, you're going to have a very hard time in this city. So we used to do it just between ourselves and then in the blog. And then we felt that this could make for a great book. So we worked on a plot over many years, and we had a lot of fun doing it, and I hope it comes across in the writing.
So I think one of the things we tried to capture in the book is really the unlikely friendship that began with us, since Phoebe's originally from London and I'm a girl from the Midwest. But we really took to one another being transplants and learning to navigate the waters in DC.
We both are strong feminists, but struggle with managing it all, with kids and careers and husbands and a household to run. And again, these are all problems of privilege, but we wanted to wrestle with that in the book. So we made Crystal's character a working mother of four, which she actually has been a lot of the time. And she moves to DC determined to have this big career, and she meets Phoebe, which is my character, who's a very strident stay-at-home mother who believes that you have to devote yourself utterly to your children in order to sort of turn out these superhumans in life, to the point where the kid doesn't know where to dispose of a used tissue without an instruction from mother. So we have we poke fun at that in the book, and Phoebe's character is very much like that, very, schedules a million things for her twin girls, and, is just determined to have them succeed in every area of life. But the problem in her life is that her entrepreneurial husband does not make enough money for her to stay at home. So she is forced to go back to work in the course of the book and deal with the trauma of finding a job when you haven't had one for many years, and the humiliation of having a boss who's 20-something when you're in your 40s. And we came up with the idea of using pen names just because we thought it would be fun, and also we weren't sure if we really wanted people who knew us to know that we were writing the story, because at one point we were worried we would offend people.
Often in DC, the desperation we'd see is going to various events and finding people of certain import, or people perhaps not even of certain import, who want to tell you how important they are. And so you really need perhaps a self-deprecating way of managing that. And so we tried to find that. Phoebe Thompson is based on a wonderful real woman named Penelope Bell.
And Crystal Walker is based on my good friend Sherry Springer. And Crystal's name, if you don't mind me telling a little backstory, we wanted to come up with a name that had a little bit of bling to it and sounded a bit like a stripper. I was a journalist originally in London, and my character in the book is a former BBC journalist. And I've noticed that in book promotional terms, people keep introducing me that way, and I want to clear the air once and for all. I've never claimed to be. But yeah, I am a former freelance journalist, technology journalist, and I also had a career in PR in London.
And still do.
Way back when. Right, I do. I both of us wear many hats, as our friends know. So.
And I am an attorney and worked in many different kinds of practices as a lawyer, large firms, smaller firms. I had a stay-at-home office as an attorney, which is perhaps the one I use the most in the book, because trying to manage work at home, especially in something where they don't like to hear screaming children in the background, can be a challenge. I've taken many business calls literally in my bathroom or closet.
And we all.
And after turning away from the law and deciding that the challenges of family needed to be met, and even finding that practicing at home didn't work so well, I actually, much like Crystal's character in the book, became a certified teacher of yoga. Yes, I am a yoga teacher. So,
question. We like to think we came up with the title Desperate in DC before Desperate Housewives came out, which shows how long we've been discussing and writing this book. But yes, I think we came up with the title partly because we had a sense of desperation about our lives here, and just I think anyone who lives here, particularly if they have kids and they're a woman, knows that struggle where they feel like they're falling down on all fronts, on their work life, their home life, their marriage, their house. Everything is on the point of, you know, chaos at any one moment on any given day. And I think the days that where it all seems to be going swimmingly are very few and far between. Maybe that's true of people everywhere.
Often in DC, the desperation we'd see is, you know, going to various events and finding people of certain import, or people perhaps not even of certain import, to want to tell you how important they are. And so you really need perhaps a self-deprecating way of managing that. And so we tried to find that, you know, in the book.